Hello everybody, welcome back once again to the Divinity walkthrough. Alright, so the last video there we had just finished up the Lakula Mines and got the spell at the bottom there, and so now we are actually able to destroy the Death Knights. And I just teleported back to Silver Glen for whatever reason, and now I am going to head to Sacred Stone. If I remember correctly, I didn't really do much here in this particular trip to Sacred Stone. There's a couple of things that you can do in the prison area here. I know one of the guards that's walking around has a key, and like you can free some of the people that are in here. But I think that will require you to fight the guards. And then, I don't remember, like, I could have swore I ended up maybe losing reputation, which, I don't know, is not that big of a deal here, anyway. Actually, really, to be honest, throughout the game, I've been able to kind of increase my standing, or however you want to say the merchant's view. Your characters by, you know, donating items to them, and then, you know, obviously the better your standing is, the better prices that you'll get when you buy and sell them. But again, I don't really remember exactly what I did here, but I guess we're gonna find out. But here there's an orc wandering around in that cell back there, and he can't fit through the gate, I guess.
What do you want? Can't you see we got a job to do? I serve the goddess, and I serve her true. Anything you need to know about me, you can find out in the Book of the Immaculates. You see prisoners, I see fuel for the goddess's plan. Yes, they've enough in them for quite a number of bloodstones. Her will be done.
Okay, so creepy immaculate jailer there. But yeah, anyways, the orc is, I think even if you open up the jail door, he can't fit through the doors, I guess. And so if you got the teleportation skill, you can teleport him outside. And then he will attack the guards and fight the guards. I don't think he makes it very far, though. Or he didn't from what I saw. And then the crummy thing is, though, like if you try to help him, like if you try to heal him, he goes hostile to you, so then he'll attack you. But otherwise, you can join in and you know, help him defeat the jailers if you want to. It looks like all of these jail doors are, you know, red. So if you try to pick the locks while people are looking, or if you're not sneaking, you are going to get busted and start a fight. So if you want to, though, you can probably, or my guess would be, steal the key from, again, one of these jailers, I'm pretty sure, has the key on them. And you could then, you know, sneak around and then unlock the bars or the jail doors.
Are you? Damn it all! I had hoped for someone who might be able to help us out of here.
It's no use
at all. Let us out of here.
I come from a village not so far to the east of here, the Hunter's Edge by name. What remains of it, I know not. Orc surprised us, and ravaged.
Free me,
and I'll be forever loyal.
And all the while, the evil Queen Gratilda presided over our misery, brandishing her carving knives with glee. I've learned my lesson with your kind.
Free me, and I'll be forever loyal.
We had a station right in our town. Well, for all her posturing as a great and powerful sorcerer.
Sort of cozy, come to think of it. Pleasure, my liege, pleasure. Oh, we're nobody. Nobody and nobody's, my liege. Well, but I suppose.
Let's see. Little keys, lockpick.
Okay, so there's there's one group of prisoners there that are they look human, and then there's another group that looks to be what were those imps or something like that. Here, this door is attached to the like the schoolhouse, but it looks like if you try to unlock it or open it right there, it'll you might get busted too, and they might not appreciate that. But at some point, I know I teleport this guy outside just to see what was going to happen, but I don't remember if it was right now or not. Maybe we can get him.
You there we go. Human! Look, I promised not to burst your skull if you help an orc out of the cell. Oh, I'm like a wailing cooking pot in here. Thor, I'm called. But I doubt anyone but me remembers that now. I've been in there nearly as long as a lifetime. Don't know why they haven't cut my throat like the rest. Maybe they've gone fond of their pet. Oh, I've been here since I was but a wee lad. Truth be told, these walls are just about all I know. But sunlight, there's something even a big oaf like myself couldn't forget. One day, Source Hunter, whether you help me or not, I'll feel sunlight again.
Alright, so that's Bruthor, and he does explain that he's been here since he was, little, and now he can't fit through the gate. But alright, so let's throw him outside here and see what happens. That'll be fun, huh? What could go wrong? What could go wrong? And then here, I don't know if I made him land on the jailers, but I'm betting that is going to make them unhappy with me. Oh, nope. It doesn't look like he actually hit him. But here, so they'll just kind of go to town and hack each other apart. Bruthor gets completely messed up. But I don't think that he has, anything else to do with the game whatsoever. And you can leave him in there. It doesn't seem to matter. I don't think he's even got really, even a quest that activates when you talk to him. Again, I don't really know what his deal is. It seems, kind of cool that you can teleport him outside, and, that's cool and everything, but they didn't really, do anything else with him. So, anyways, he's about to eat it here, and what did I do? Did I attack the jailers, I think, here? So now I'm all involved in these misdeeds. And there you go. Yeah, so there. I think I tried to heal Bruthor just to see what would happen, and that turned him hostile to me. So I don't know. That's a goofy thing about this game. It seems like if you try to heal anybody, they get unhappy with you. So it's kind of strange, but whatever. All right, so we'll load her back up here. Yeah, I don't know. Again, do whatever you want in here. It doesn't seem to affect anything whatsoever in the storyline. I don't know if you kill the jailers again. I don't remember, but I thought that I got a reputation hit when I killed some of them. So maybe we'll find that out for sure here, or at least I suspect I did. Maybe not. Nope, I guess not. I decided it was time to get out of Dodge. one of the things that I really should have done there at the beginning of the video, though, was I was obviously in Silver Glen, and I have Drexus's head. He's the goblin that was in the mine, and you can finish the quest there from Lawrence by, I think, kind of proving that you've defeated him. But I forgot to do that, so Yeah, that's a little unfortunate, and thus I definitely missed out on some experience. I think that's really all you get, though. I don't know if there's any other. I should say that I'm fairly certain there isn't any other reward for that. But by all means, check that out. So I'm heading up here, and I'm not really sure why. I think if I remember correctly, I thought that I had missed something up here, and I don't think I actually did. Now there's lava everywhere, and I'm kind of boned without the... And I never did, unfortunately, and I've mentioned it a few times in the other videos, but I had meant to try out the ability, the scoundrel ability, Winged Feet, to try to hover over, like, the lava and stuff, throughout the game, but I never did that, so... Maybe that will be my, fourth playthrough? I'll have to remake that a new goal in another, or for another Look time out. That I play the game, but I managed to get all the way through the game again without doing it, so. But one of these times I'll do it. I'll try it out, but apparently not this time. And I was hoping that I, could get to that switch back there, but again, I think without some way to float over the lava, I don't think I can get to it, so. But yeah, other than that, I thought that there was something up here, that's why I came back. But I just ended up kind of wasting some time here, and, didn't really accomplish much. So I think maybe what I'll do is I'll just cut, some of the rest of this stuff out. Okay. So I just noticed I spent about 5 more minutes, monkeying around in that area, trying to figure out what I could do, but, anyways, alright, so we're gonna head back here to the witch's hut, and I forgot what I had to do here, but I think there's a way to remove this barrier, and I don't remember what it was. Blossius's will. I did eventually remember to take Blossius's will into the tavern. That's where I think her name is Marissa, and she if you give anyways, that'll be coming up in a few more videos. So I did actually remember, or at least remember, to take care of that. Alright, what am I looking for here? Barrier removal spell. There it is. I have no idea where I got this from. It appears Maradino had some talent mixed in with all that hot air. My bad, sorry. I don't know where that came from. But that's what it's for. There we go. So, let's see what this... What was that piece of veils? You found a way to open the barrier without hurting any mushrooms? And that's the other way to get rid of the barrier. You can just kill the mushrooms there. If I remember correctly, though, they've got, like, elemental immunities, so, you have to attack specific ones, or I should say specific ones are immune to certain types of damage, so that can be a little bit of an annoyance if you're using wands like I am. But, all right, anyway, this is Ikara's hut, and... I don't think she's got anything particularly useful up here. Maybe the mycology? Actually, I don't... Now that I think about it, I don't think that was very useful at all either. Okay, good enough. Let's get going here. Okay, so, I don't know where this actually... teleports you to, or if it's just downstairs, or like this is supposed to be her basement.
As good as a new
I mean, I think stairs would have been fine, but I guess Ikara likes to, travel to her basement in style. All right, so there's another book there about rifts. I don't know if that's useful either. I don't remember that, doing anything, but magical tragedies, same deal. I don't know if that's actually for anything. I got a closet key. I don't actually know what that's for. Although that says it says there's a closet right there, so maybe it's for that. It's a little weird though, because most of the closets in this game aren't locked. But who knows? Maybe that one is. Okay. Do-do-do-do. Bunch of garbage. I don't know if there was anything useful in the bottom of her place here either. Oh, there we go. Staff kit part one. Branch. Okay.
What's that gleam?
So if you are crafting yourself the staff that uses the kit, maybe grab that. There's an ornate chest. There wasn't anything
I've spotted something
I was impressed
interesting.
With there. The button on the wall opens up this door. And we've got secrets of the scroll books on the floor. Oh, there we go. I think that's what that was for, that key. Because that looks like a pretty unique item to be just hiding out in a closet. Okay, I've hidden something or there's secured anything of value in a chest that none will manage to find, but there's nowhere I can hide myself from the horrors that await me. Well, that sounds frightening. There is a chest coming up here that we will...
So we'll look everywhere. Did you expect to find it marked on your map?
Okay. So there's a chest that's coming up here that is referred to in that diary, and I will obviously uncover that. Speaking of Drexus's head... Riffs. Oh, I suppose that book is somewhat appropriate for the area. We've got a rift actually coming up here. So there's a... Well, it's a rift that connects this area to Hyberheim, which has been alluded to or talked about or brought up a few times throughout the game already. But we have... Actually, we did go there. Super early on, there's the...
But who knows to what dark purpose the witch might have turned it? Keep your senses sharp for any sign of source.
Sign of source, okay. There's the well that teleports you there. Unfortunately, because of where the well is at, you can't do anything in Hyberheim, when you first arrive there. But you do at least get to sneak a peek. But we will be heading there here in a little bit. It's going to be... No, it won't be this video. It'll at least be the next one.
I don't doubt it. The question is why?
What's this? I've found something. All right. Well, let's dig it up then. Oh, that's right. Okay. There are a couple of spots on the ground in this cave that just like kind of explode with mushrooms when you dig it up.
A beautiful view indeed. To think this sanctuary has been compromised by dark forces. Forces you can combat.
Did that puddle just address us? Either that, or our judgment's been addled by mushroom spores.
Awesome. Did that puddle just address us? Either that, or our judgment's been addled by mushroom spores? Epic. All right, so if you've got enough perception, you can you'll spot this dirt pile here. I don't know what the requirement is, but this is the chest that was talked to. Talked about.
Come to the lake. I'll reveal all.
Okay. So apparently these were the things of value, which I am not one bit impressed by, but that's okay. So that was the chest that was mentioned in the tattered... Was it the tattered diary or whatever?
Something interesting.
Oh, and here's another pile.
Ready to advance. Ready to...
This is another mushroom explosion. Boom! Yep. I don't remember what earth tongue mushrooms were for. To be honest, I've never really looked into... I'm assuming it's like potion making or something. But I didn't do any of that, I think, in any of the playthroughs that I've ever done. So I have no idea, unfortunately, what those actually make. But, alright, so we've got a battle here, and you'll want to be careful when you start this one out, because the enemies kind of, they kind of jump you, I guess I'd say. And they Here, yeah, I didn't even notice these ones that were right next to me. If you notice the mini-map, though, you can see them there. I just didn't really look at that, I guess. But, yeah, they kind of jump out behind these plants and ferns, and then there's a bunch across this bridge. Which, that part's not that big of a deal. If you want to summon a couple of things on the bridge, that's not such a bad idea. Or if you've got melee characters, you know, you can kind of hang back until the enemies get a little bit closer. Take care of the enemies that are, you know, immediately around you. But yeah, other than that, not a whole lot else to say about this battle. This is pretty easy. This guy's kind of rough, though. He's got a bit of, looks like he's got a bit of health. Although he's, what, level 10? And I'm level 22, so, okay. Kind of sad. Alright. I think that's it for the enemies that are behind us. So the rest of them should be coming across the bridge. So again, if you want to, or if you feel like you need to, you can summon some, summons or something and stick them on the bridge. And kind of do a bit of a battle at the bridge, if you wanted to. Maybe drop some Gandalf quotes. I don't know, it seems appropriate. Okay. I think this is it. That marksman there is the last of the immaculate scum that we need to deal with. Alright, so let's teleport her up here. Have her say hi. Get her introduced to the party. Show her our wands. And, oh, that looked like that hurt. Sorry. Alright, let's continue on here. It didn't look like any of those Immaculates really had anything decent. Okay, so quite a bit of a crossroads here. A dead chicken. Oh man, fried chicken. I could go for some right now.
I spotted something interesting.
All right, I think this is another mushroom pile. Bloop. Oh, just one? Really? Mediocre. All right.
Meet me at the lake, Source Hunter. Do not delay.
Meet me by the lake, Source Hunter. Do not delay. Well, I've got some news for you, friend. We're going to be taking a bit of a detour to destroy some more immaculate scum. Come here over here, rat. Come here. Come on now. I don't know if I actually got a hold of this rat or not to talk to it, but I guess we'll see. Alright, so this area, there's some flaming, I don't know, something on the ground, or at least a little bit. I just wanted to put that out before I started this fight. And there, I really should have started this off by summoning a decapitator up there, but I mean, we'll be fine, but still. Got one summoned up. Oh, number two.
Legions of the lifeless, heed my call.
Legions of the lifeless, heed my call. Yeah, do that for sure. You're definitely gonna want to heed our call.
I bind you in solemn battle oath.
Bind you in solemn oath? Yeah, do that. That sounds like fun. Why not? So what do we got here? There's a couple of, I don't know if there's an Immaculate Marksman around here somewhere. Probably. Definitely a few summoners. I see at least three caster types. There's a Fire Elemental back there, too. So, be careful if you're... Actually, two of them now that I see it. So, you'll have to be careful if you're using fire-based weapons or fire spells. I think I've got still a bunch of fire wands equipped on my character, so that's a bit of a problem, but I suspect I'll just have my decapitators do the work for me. But yeah, this ends up being a pretty big battle here. There's got to be at least seven or eight guys here, or enemies. Alright, Medora's all buffed up and ready to go. So, really like this combination of, both of desecration and rage combined. It's absolutely brutal. Boom! Oh my gosh, that's so mean. Okay, let's go finish you off. I really should have started on the, excuse me. On the fire elementals. That the fire elemental on the left there, if you notice, I didn't even see him. Because he would have been a way closer target for me to start on, but I didn't even see him. Alright, here we've got our recruited Immaculate here doing some work for us. Good old charm. Alright, so yeah, here was the other flame elemental. And now here I think I'm gonna run into some problems here because all my characters are kind of bunched up back here. I've got a charmed person in my way, a fire elemental in my way, and it's Ambrosia. I don't remember what she was equipped with. Yeah, but here it's trying to target the elemental because he's right in my face. All up in my grill. Yeah, I don't know what that is. Oh, yeah, she does have a fire wand. Alright, so I guess I just decided to go after the charmed one. If you're gonna stand right in my way. Oh, that's another fire wand. On Morel here. This should work. There we go. Let me get a good angle on this. Ranger, black, ooh, nighty night, and then okay, there we go. Now I don't have to worry about him being in my way as I'm trying to kill people. I was trying to pick up that bow off the ground. Whoopsies. All right. Yeah, throw that chair. What is this, the DNC convention? Oh. Har, har, har. All right, Immaculate Ranger. Oh, boy. All right, so one more left. I think it's the one that got knocked down, and I didn't notice that. Right there. There we go. I guess I did notice it. There we go. All right. So that's that. That was quite the fight, or it could have been quite the fight if I wasn't, 12 levels over them.
Soaked to the skin.
Soaked to the skin, and baking like a cake. Okay. We've got here some. Potions. A bunch of garbage. All kinds of garbage. Fun with fluids. Sounds inappropriate. I don't know. And a chest with some absolute garbage in it. Alright. I think that's pretty much it. Yeah, we're done here. Time to move on. Okay. Alright, so that's pretty much actually it for this video. The rest is pretty much going to be a conversation with another imp, Rickzax or something like that, which sounds like it was an imp that knew Ikara or knows Ikara, and yeah, he'll have some, less than really informational things to say, but him or her, whatever it is. But that's it. As always, hope the guide was helpful, and hope you join me for more videos. Thanks for watching.
You're here. Ikara, the witch. She's been taken. Immaculates everywhere. Ikara, she's been kidnapped, taken, carried off. It's... they are
That much I know for sure. She's been plotting her revenge for years now. I told Ikara, but she wouldn't believe it. And now look! The grotto's overrun with murderers! Ikara's been kidnapped! And God knows what else the Andrew's planning! Haven't you had to look around? This place is infested with immaculate. They just as soon slit my throat as blow their noses. Yours too, you know. Two reasons. Two very terrible reasons. Don't you know? These immaculates answer to Leandra alone. The conduit, my hiney. Second, Leandra's had it out for Ikara for 2 long years. When she left here, she was... hate machine! Eyes blazing, steam coming from her nose, almost. Why, I lived among them both for years. Leandra and I never quite took to one another, but Ikara is my protector, my friend. Some years ago, a wizard came to join them here, Zandalore. He and Ikara fell in love, which drove Leandra batty! She stormed away and disappeared for 2 long years. As far as I know, she never said word one to her sister or Zandalore during all that time. Ikara! Oh, dear Ikara! Oh, she protected me when no one else would. She'd care for any who asked. Dear, wonderful Ikara. I escaped to a grotto from Ibaheim. Oh, a terrible place. Oh, I get the shivers just thinking about it. I begged her for asylum, and she agreed before I'd even finished my plea. Oh, dear, dear Ikara. Slaughterized, torture, enslavement. A terrible place for all, but for an imp, there is no worse hell. Hundreds of my brothers toil there still, building the king's mazes and prisons. Oh, I'm the only one who managed a way out. Poor lost brothers. And that is just where they've taken her, Sorzanta. They've taken Ikara to that frigid abyss. Yippee! Will you go then? Will you find her? Oh, good! Oh, wonderful! To the lake then, friend. The lake. It can be used for rift travel between this realm and that. That's where they took her. That's where you must go. You're telling me? Please, your Santa, you must find Ikara. If you claim to fight for order and good, there's no one else you'd sooner save.